And we know that true progress is going to take real work. And this is a moment of transformation in our city if we can actually come together.
Mayor Frey told reporters the work of police reform will continue regardless of the outcome of ballot question two.
So I think something that needs to be recognized, perhaps nationwide right now, is that cops need to get paid more and fired more.
He said one key will be recruiting officers with deeper connections to the communities they're serving and finding ways to make it easier to hold police accountable for misconduct.
Now is an opportunity to work collectively with the state legislature around real reform. You should hold mayors and chiefs around the country accountable for shifting the culture of a police department.
Frey will start his second term with more power than any previous mayor because question one passed, giving him more control over city operations. Previously, those functions were handled by an executive committee that included the mayor and four council members.
We can set up a government that is more responsive, that is more effective, and is more collaborative. That's the direction that we need to go, and we're taking this measure and this approach very, very seriously and getting that work slingshot right off the bat.
Now, Frey also thanked Black, Latino, and Somali voters for their support, especially people on the north side who he described as the backbone of his support. You may recall he didn't win outright the first choice vote, so they went to ranked choice tabulations. He drew enough second choice votes from candidates who were eliminated from the bottom of the stack to win today. Now, one thing you'll notice here from these stats is that Kate Knuth, who finished third in the first round of the first choice votes, pulled into second place today based on the strength of the second choice support. So those second choice votes didn't change the winner in the mayor's race, but they did alter the final places of those behind Frey in the pack. And that means that in all four ranked choice city elections in Minneapolis history, dating back to 2009, whoever won in first choice votes went on to win the race.
Huh, interesting. All right, thank you, John.